Ladies and gentlemen, everyone in this episode refuses to die without a fight. Make sure you're subscribed if you haven't already, and leave a like if you enjoy. Let's hop right back in with ATR doing her best Trinomir cosplay. Oh god, the temptation to hit that blue buff. Next up, Akali is ready to die for this Indiv, but not really. Know your limits, know your enemy, and know your battlefield. This is one mega tanky Udyr, but that's a vein. Keep a close eye on her targeting though. She thinks Udyr's dead already and doesn't finish that last silver bolts proc. She swaps to minions and then Yasuo, and let's just say they really needed that true damage. Shout out to the Winions and GP's Cannon Barrage for that turnaround. Next up, it's a good thing Yone's Q3 hitbox starts from a behind hit.
I'm so dead in my man.
Zag je die oude playtest? Of ja of nee?
This self-save is literally frame-perfect. This explosive shot does 390 damage and Nezap is below 300, and the Honey Fruit healed exactly 98.
We can't kill him. nice in his god-forbidden game, bro. Holy f***ing one. What the f***?
That's what I call a triumphant spin to win. And speaking of spinning to win, it's Fireboy. And don't be fooled, this is a Samira with a Garen skin, and either way, there's gonna be spinning and winning. There's 10 seconds left on the W cooldown, but against Jax's Counter-Strike, Alainzon can't wait. He pops the all-out to reset the cooldown and pierces right through the Counter-Strike for the Triumph, Heal, and Turnaround.
Yes,
No auto with red smite means no burn, and Urpog lives to see another day. This man is full of calculations, and that wasn't even his main. This is, and this is the Kindle Gem tech. Keep an eye on the health bar. I don't actually know if Arshako ever looks at his own health while taking this wave. He's just hyper focused on getting Silas to run into his box.
Oof, close.
It was a 2v2 top, but now Graves is dead. Kog and Diana are looking for Lol AFK farm, and he decides to take the fight to them. The second he flashes in, Kog is ready to be a sacrifice, but Diana wants no part of it.
Now.
Kindred had ult that fight, I just don't think she was mentally prepared. Next up, make sure you always keep an eye on your levels and the level gap. If Riven gives this wave, she might as well forfeit the game, but she can smell Nasus' bloodthirst and all she needs is that perfectly timed shield.
Morgen? Warum reparte Manik? Man schaut, das ist ein Ding. Thanks so much for watching. That is going to do it for today's episode all on 1 HP moments. Remember to leave a like if you did enjoy and subscribe for some more good stuff like this daily. Until next time, take care, stay safe, and have yourself a wonderful day.